What happened today? 1. President Vladimir Putin agreed to hold a nationwide vote to allow Russians to have their say on a raft of changes to the country's constitution on April 22. 2. Teenage climate activist Greta Thunberg, pro-democracy campaigners in Hong Kong and the NATO military alliance are among those tipped for the 2020 Nobel Peace Prize, following nominations by politicians. 3. President Donald Trump assured Americans the risk from coronavirus remained very low, and placed Vice President Mike Pence in charge of the U.S. response to the looming global health crisis. 4. Saudi Arabia temporarily suspended entry to the kingdom for the Umrah Islamic pilgrimage and visits to Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi in Medina, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs announced on Twitter amid fears over the spread of the new coronavirus. 5. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi appealed for peace in Delhi after days of Hindu-Muslim clashes over a disputed new citizenship law sparked some of the worst sectarian violence seen in the capital in decades. 6. The U.S. Embassy in New Delhi urged its citizens to be cautious after violent clashes broke out between Hindus and minority Muslims. 7. Julian Assange appeared before a British court for a third day to fight an extradition request from the United States, which wants to put the 48-year-old on trial for hacking government computers and violating an espionage law. 8. Tunisia's parliament began debating and looked set to approve a new coalition government, after months of political wrangling that has slowed the North African country's efforts to tackle looming economic problems. 9. Parties to Iran's nuclear deal made little progress towards saving the agreement as Iran is still breaching many of its central terms in response to U.S. sanctions. 10. Turkey plans to push Syrian government forces away from its military observation posts in northwest Syria's Idlib region this week, President Tayyip Erdogan said, despite advances by Damascus's Russian-backed military. 11. Panasonic Corp said it would exit solar cell production at Tesla Inc.'s New York plant, the latest sign of strain in a partnership where Panasonic's status as the U.S. electric vehicle (EV) maker's exclusive battery supplier is ending. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more What Happened Today videos.